Welcome to the next episode of 5 Minutes Serverless First. This episode is going to be in continuation with the previous episode, where we talked about Azure Functions and integration with Virtual Network or VNET. In the previous episode, we talked about the benefits of integrating Azure Functions with Virtual Network. And in the previous episode, at the end of the previous episode, I left you with a bit of a cliffhanger, if you can call it that. What are some of the downsides of integrating your Azure Functions with the Virtual Network? Let's take a look at that. First and foremost, you have to deal with this additional complexity of setting up the Virtual Network. You have to deal with something called the dedicated subnets. Anytime you have to integrate Azure Functions into a VNet, you have to have a dedicated subnet, and there are some known limitations around that. For example, you need to know the size of the IP pool that is associated with a dedicated subnet, because you cannot change it once it has been provisioned, things like that. The next limitation that you may have to deal with is the cold start. We talked about the cold start problem in the earlier episodes. That cold start may be extended because now you're depending on resources within your virtual network. And finally, you have to deal with additional costs. In order to take advantage of the VNet integration, you have to be paying for the premium or the dedicated SKU. But more importantly, you're not able to take advantage of the consumption plan. As we have seen previously, in the consumption plan, you're only paying for the number of times the function is getting invoked. And additionally, you're able to scale seamlessly as part of the consumption plan. So looks like there are some downsides. So when would you be looking at integrating your Azure Functions with Virtual Network, and when can you take advantage of the consumption plan that we have talked about? So what are some of the requirements that can help you determine if a virtual network integration is required or not? First and foremost, perhaps you want to access resources inside a virtual network, such as a virtual machine. Perhaps you want to access a resource that may be running on-premises, going over an express route circuit, or a VPN tunnel. If you have these requirements, you will need integration with the virtual network. Consider additional requirements. Maybe you have a requirement to lock down your function app behind a VNet so that there is no public IP address that's involved. And I want you to think more deeply about this requirement. Of course, you can take your function app, put it inside a VNet, as we have seen previously. But you can also leave your function app on the internet, but secure it using either the IP filtering or authenticating against Azure AD. There are a number of services out there that are available on the internet that support an Azure AD-based authentication. In fact, I'll show you an example of that. The other requirement to consider is the following. So you may want to access PaaS services such as storage or SQL database over a private endpoint. And once again, if you absolutely have a requirement to send all of the packets over a private connection, then of course you will need a VNet integration. But once again, I encourage you to think more deeply about this requirement. And why am I asking you to reconsider some of these things here? Let's take a look. Do we really always need a VNet integration? So first and foremost, in general, the trend within security is that security is moving to the edge. So we are seeing, in addition to the software-defined networking, all of the security associated with networking is moving to the edge as well. And this is part of the bigger phenomenon of inversion, where your data center is being replaced by cloud, your network is being replaced by collection of cloud data centers on the internet. So the security has to move to the edge in any case. As I said earlier, your functions can still be protected using Azure AD, something that you're already consuming, number of SaaS services that you may already be consuming. And keep in mind that the underlying infrastructure that powers your functions, whether it is VMs or VM scale sets, those are, of course, inside the virtual network. Also consider things like the Azure Function middleware. This is something that's an evolving concept. I have a slide about that in a moment. But you can take advantage of things like injecting a piece of code within your functions to do certain things. For example, you can protect the egress traffic. So you can inject a middleware that looks for all of the packets that are going out, and if they meet certain conditions, only then they are allowed. So you have a number of choices that are available. Once again, we are moving towards a security in the edge model, taking advantage of Azure AD authentication along with Azure Functions, taking advantage of things like a middleware to protect your egress traffic, maybe just enough to get you the requirements that you're trying to achieve using VNet. And of course, the benefit is that you get all of the benefits of the consumption-based plan. With this, we come to the end of this episode. Here are some links that will allow you to explore the topics that we have talked about in a little bit more detail. Thank you once again for watching, and please send us your feedback. See you in the next episode.